Thank you. sacrifices the human being above environment. Environmental issues. Specifically, what we call trees.
Yeah.
Now, next point. Nobody will speak. I will name. Yes, not for what was the next point? Poet compares trees with humans, human beings. Next, that is. Yes, cutting a tree doesn't lead to its end. These were the points we discussed yesterday in three stanzas. The last, I guess, four stanzas we have discussed. And fifth stanza I'll be discussing after you will be telling me. So four students I'll be choosing. Those who will be explaining those four stanzas which we done, which we have covered yesterday. Yeah. So these are the points. Now you can raise your hand those who want to tell the content of first stanza. It takes much time to kill a tree, not a simple jab of the night. Very good, I'll appreciate that. It has grown slowly, consuming the earth. Online children can also raise hand. Yes, those who want to speak the first stanza. Now who is raising hands? Because we have to speak a lot in this. That's why have confidence, you know the answer. Yes, that you speak. Very good. Next stanza you will speak. Okay, okay. A single blow of knife cannot cut a tree. It needs a lot of effort. Then, very good. So Prachi has given accurate explanation in the first stanza. Poet says that it takes much time for the sprouting of the tree, for the seeds. Then it takes its nutrients from the soil. The process is very lengthy and time consuming. Fine. And it absorbs years of sunlight, air, water. And it's not that easy. And the process which takes a lot of time. And do you expect that with a single jab of knife you can cut that tree? No, it's not possible because the formation process, it takes years. So you cannot expect a single jab of knife to kill it. So it takes time in the first stanza. Second stanza, yes, Vida, you want to speak? The process is still not over. Very good. So your name is?
Yeah.
Yes, Visham. But you check your notebook. There are some problems in that, okay? I remember. That's why I said. So hack and chop and this long won't do it. So Rishan has also given accurate explanation. That is the second stanza. Poet G. Patel says that hacking and chopping. Here, hack doesn't mean bad hacking with the computer system. Here, hack and chop is like related to cutting, right? Yes, cutting and trimming of the tree, exactly. So, but this alone will not help it. When we think that we have cut a tree, it fell down on the ground, the process is not over. Bleeding bark will heal and from close to the ground. So we people who cut the tree will think that okay, it is on the ground, it is over. No, but there are roots. roots are still bound in the earth and if remain unnoticed or unchecked, it will again come emerge out of the land in the form of a twig, and then it will again take its form of the plant, and again branches will come out and it will become a full blooming tree if remain unchecked by you. Even if you cut a tree, the process is not over because roots are quite deeper in the land. Clear? Yes, you want to say something? First stanza, not paragraph. Yes, Jatin will speak first stanza.
In first stanza, poet talks about the root of the tree, and he told that if we don't cut or snap out the root, it will not be the end of the tree. So, and it is the most sensitive and hidden part of the tree, which is inside the tree.
Change some seeds over there, no? That group also, obviously too. So very good, Jatin. The root is to be pulled out in the first stanza. Now, Vita, it's very easy language. In the first stanza, poet says that it's not easy to cut a tree. Right? Outline, I'm just saying. Because it takes, he stresses upon the formation years of the tree, how it grows. In the second stanza, poet says that even if you cut a tree, it's not over. The process is still pending because it has roots deeper into the land. In the third stanza, now poet is telling us that all you can is the complete process of cutting the tree or killing of the tree. So why? See, otherwise, killing wood is not used for trees or non-living things because poet has personified the trees and environment here. He has given human qualities to trees and plants. He is saying they also breathe. So he is making comparison of trees and human beings. That's why he uses the breathing bark and such kind of phrases in this. Yeah, that's why he named the poem. He could name it cutting of a tree also. So he is trying to evoke our souls to say that if you cut a tree, you are not cutting it, you are killing it. It's a murder only. So he is considering the process of cutting equivalent to murder. In the beginning, which quote I made you write that day? In the beginning. Yes, Jade, you wrote. Yes, when we cut a tree, we cut our lives. Because trees give us oxygen and we cut a tree, we are so happy. We need oxygen to survive. Lack of oxygen, more problems. Already see people are having breathing problems. Some people are having problems with the lungs. Right? Different people are having many issues with the breathing system and all. So many ailments and diseases will be vanished if we plant more and more trees, more pure air. Right? In that way, poet is trying to evoke us that you are killing the tree, not cutting the tree. So, clear all of you? Now let's do the last stanza. Then the matter. Have you done or pulled out entirely? Have you done that? Done? Okay, page 111, last stanza. Then the matter of scorching and choking in sun and air, browning, hardening, twisting, withering, and then it is done. So now he is telling that when you are killing a tree, it's not a single jab of knife. You have to put in multiple jabs. You need to put in a lot of efforts to cut the branches, the trunk, the leaves, and then even you have to pull out the roots. But even then, the process is not enough, even after pulling the roots. So he's saying that it's like, when a person dies due to he's not getting breathing, you can represent them good really. It's like that he's trying to tell us that no, I'm not saying you cannot compare any ailment here. I'm saying that when a person is not able to breathe, he dies. Right? That is the end. Similarly, we have smashed the breathing system of the tree from it by pulling the roots. Now it's not able to breathe. Then we pull out the roots out of it. Yeah? Then the metal is scorching and choking the sun and air. That's how it will be done later on. Scorching heat will dry up the moist in the sand or that place where the tree was erected. By rest part. So poet is trying to say that rest of the work will be done by the sunlight, right? And then the hardening after the sunlight, that place will be hardened where once the tree was standing, right? Roots are gone, no trace will be found. And see the meaning of scorching and choking is written, but drying up of the tree after being uprooted. Even after being uprooted, it's not rising. It is not a time to complete your work. Let's complete the work, which is complete, ordinated. Please, one more. I need not tell that. This is not a three period you are doing this. So, drying up of the tree after being uprooted. Here in the scorching heat, that is mentioned. And after getting severe sunlight, right, after getting hardened, it will become more hardened, that place. And withering is like it's vanished only now. Everything is totally finished. And then it is done. Then you can say that you have killed a tree. I'm not saying you have cut a tree. So poet is actually telling us that this process takes time, slowly and steadily. You have to, so you are the murderer actually, who is killing the tree. This is what he is trying to say. Clear? Now, what is the theme of the poem already discussed? Poet is trying to create, he has given emphatic form to it. Sympathy and empathy, many over five is to create. Sympathy is when we have kindness, feeling of kindness towards others. Empathy is when we put ourselves at place of others. So poet is trying to sensitize us. Aapki sensitivity chala raha hai. He's saying that just like human beings, they are also living things. Right? They also are helping us to provide oxygen to us, to provide so many things to us. So you should be sensitive enough, you should have patience and he compares tree to the human being, that is also one of the themes. And these, another theme is cutting a tree, not really cutting, it is just like a killing the tree or murdering the tree. Clear? So with that, we will be now discussing the question answers. Raise your hand, those who want to answer. Otherwise, I will name the child. Yes, poetic devices. Sir, when I discuss the personification, please share that. Attendance with our online children, Kathy, Nianshita, Sindheen, Pratiksha, Raghav Kumar. Online children, is it clear to you all? Please send me your feedback. Yes. Only Nianshita has sent me thumbs up. What about others? Okay, we can do two questions with that. First question. Can a simple jab of knife, yes, Prachi is the one to raise hand. Kill a tree, why not? Listen to the answers. We are going to discuss. Please have attention. Navesh. Firstly, I have to tell yes or no. See, again, one problem in the answer. Can a simple jab of knife kill a tree? No. A simple jab of knife cannot kill a tree. You are starting the answer with a pronoun. Right? That is not allowed. If you have the pronoun, you should take it. Okay? So now repeat again. Very good. So, no, comma. You will also put a comma. A simple jab of knife cannot kill a tree. We are discussing the answers. You can note down some value points. I do not want you copy paste on your friend. Whatever point you want to note down, whatever I'll be discussing, just take notes in the comma very easy for you. Clear? So poet says, no, a simple jab of the knife does not have the ability to fill a tree, right? It has to go through various processes, right? It has to go through various processes. If its root is uprooted, you can say if its root is not removed, right, from the earth, it can sprout again, or it sprouts again, not can, but it will definitely. It will sprout again. The process of rejuvenation of the tree is active. It is ready. Clear? Any doubt to anyone? Clear to all? Yes. Second question. How has the tree grown to its full size? List the words suggestive of its life and activity. Raise your hand. In this video, you have to tell the natural ingredients, natural resources which it uses. Only one child is raising hand. What about others? Same child cannot get the turn again. Jaldi pehle hone wali hai. Yes. Yes, find the simple answer. That's it. To the point, you need to answer. The tree consumes the earth, fine, and rises out of it, feeding upon its crust. The tree absorbs years of sunlight, air, water. Fine? But one thing more. You, when a person is asked, name anything for it, what do? You start making points 1, 2, 3, 4. In English, you are not supposed to. Always write in the form of a paragraph. Okay, rest. Rest is a form of a paragraph.